last week, you've learned about the vocabulary words for your Unit 1. And of course, we also talked about the rhythm, which is a regularly repeating patterns or a beat that we normally associate with sound. Rhythm also represents in the visual art, and we can learn to recognize it through lines, colors, shape, form, value, or space. Okay, they are arranged or repeated. So last week, we also talked about the natural environment, okay, or the rhythm in the environment, right? It can appear as a regular pattern of colors, line, shape, and space. So we also talked about some examples that you can find in our nature that has natural rhythm. The first one is the clouds. The clouds' size and shapes change slowly and gracefully over time. And we have also the tentacles of anemone that have similar shapes, but they're different sizes. And we have also the sea urchin. Okay, they have the same shape, but they point different directions. And the last one, we have the lotus seeds. It shows repetitive rhythm. For today's lesson, we will proceed with the man-made objects. So man-made objects have both rhythm of shape and rhythm of colors. Even though color may vary, good positioning can make them appear more harmonious with a graceful rhythm. Our man-made objects, we have four examples. And the first one is the colorful pillars. It appears more harmonious with a good positioning of each pillars, even though it has alternate colors. Next is modern chair. It has a rhythm of color and rhythm of shape. A piece of cake. It shows in the picture that it has a rhythm of colors that represents the flavors. Lastly is colorful kites. It has the rhythm of color and rhythm of shape. So those are our some examples for man-made objects. So most likely it has the rhythm of colors and shape. Now let's proceed with the rhythm and position in visual arts. In visual arts, rhythm is something that you can see. The line, space, shape, and color of a composition all have a rhythm, which may have a feeling of movement, giving a flowing rhythm. If objects are equally spaced and all are similar size and color, then they may produce a regular rhythm, depending on the mood and intentions of the artist. There are many different ways to create visual arts, and these are the materials and drawing tools. We can use tools like colored pencils, poster colors, watercolors to create a picture, or we can use pencil and pens for line drawing. Now let's proceed with comparing pieces of visual arts by different kinds of materials and methods. This flower is Krajiao. The large white flower stands out among the regular and repetitive rhythm of the pink flowers, creating an attractive composition. This picture is photograph. Now let's use this picture to create visual arts with different ways using the materials and drawing tools. The first one is line drawing. This black and white line drawing separates line from the shape of the Krajiao flower. The strong lines formed by a pencil or pen show the rhythm and position of the flowers. The line drawing allows us to see position and rhythm more clearly and illustrate the beautiful grace of nature. The second one is drawn using colored pencil. As drawing lines, you can create a rhythm of color and position by using a hatching technique. The picture shows hatching from left to right and from top to bottom. Using colored pencils, hatching creates a texture, surface that can make the picture more interesting. And the last picture, drawn using watercolor. Watercolor provides translucent color. Different colors seeping into each other produce a beautiful rhythm. In the figure, hatching the bulk of the picture with a light green color, and then hatching the flowers with a strong and light rhythm, separates the flower from the leaves. The image is finished using dark green hatching. In visual arts, we use different materials and drawing tools to show the rhythm and feelings of an object. So that's all for today, class. I hope you understand the man-made rhythm and rhythm and position in visual arts.